Alright, hello everybody and welcome back to another War Thunder video. So this one is going to be part of the matches series most likely. And this is post-commentary, so you won't be able to hear the sound in the actual game. And this is one of the reasons why I don't like to do commentary sometimes on the gameplay videos, because sometimes you get a match like this, but the commentary, I get really, really, really pissed in the match. And so, I just don't like to upload it because of that. So, well, obviously, since I'm doing some post-commentary, I've decided I wanted to upload this. Now this is, I don't want to spoil the end of the match or anything, but I'm going to try my hardest in this match. And I'm trying to do battle tasks, right? So I'm in my Panther 2, but I think my battle task is to get some kind of achievement. Like, there's a whole bunch of different, like, Survivor, Heavy Metal Hero, any of those kinds. You know, get one of those achievements or whatever to win. Or to get the battle task. But then I decided, you know, I really want to win this match or something after a while. So anyways, it's here on Finland, wintry map, and I've moved forward into my favorite little vantage point. It's not really a vantage point, but it's my favorite position on this map that I usually push for when I get the northern spawn. I notice somebody's moving on A on the enemy team, and it's a T-92. I can get a nice snapshot here before he gets away. It wasn't really a snapshot, and unfortunately, I don't kill him, so he starts capping the zone. Bit disappointing. First thing that kind of ticked me off a little bit. Didn't really piss me off, but it was just kind of annoying that he didn't die or get immobilized. I was hoping my team could actually win this match. And there's a reason why I'm going to say my team. But anyways, I notice this PT-76, he starts moving forward, and there's my first kill of the match. So easy peasy straight through, only three crew members I think that tank has. And I knocked out enough of his crew, I guess. Or maybe I knocked out his ammo or something, I can't tell, I see smoke. Whatever I did, I killed him. And I pull back this direction, turn my tank around so I can get some shots on some tanks over here. And there's that T-92. Yes, I can finish this guy off. Aim and shoot. But doesn't matter because Gaijin still are way too lazy to fix the invisible rocks on the Finland map. These rocks are fucking everywhere. And that right there was one instance of it happening. Basically, the collision of the rock, it's an invisible collision thing. But anyways, I knocked out a Panther, then I knock out a Tiger. And I'm trying to keep them back from the A point long enough for that heavy tank on my team to hopefully push forward and get into the point. And I'm trying to look for that fucking T-92. So that there also pissed me off. Now I'm even getting even more pissed off because the game's starting to treat me like shit with this fucking invisible wall bullshit. But I start pulling out the other direction here. And I can see on the minimap there's some kind of medium tank to my right, so I'm being cautious of that, and a friendly's moving on him, it looks like. And I notice this T-92 way the fuck over there, but he seems to be in cover. Then all of a sudden an enemy Panther D shows up on the other side of those trees, and I'm worried that he's going to pull out, because a Panther D can still pen the front of my turret and do some damage. So I'm a little worried about this guy. I drop artillery on... Ooh! Okay, I managed to shoot this guy, get his fuel tank, so he catches on fire. I dropped artillery on that other medium tank. He pulls back, so I only have a shot on his engine, so I decide to take a shot, engine, radiator, all that stuff, and then he explodes to a T-26, and I get an assist. I get another assist for the T-92 that I had damaged earlier. And I start to move out now that the area is somewhat clear. It's not really that clear. And I get this green at point blank, another example of why the arcade marker is bullshit. Green at almost point blank range, and it ricochets. So I shoot into his turret and notice that all he has is one crew member left, but I decide to go for a side shot anyways, just to ensure the kill. And I knock out my fourth target, I think. Fifth target, maybe. And I see we've got a few things over here. We've got a T-92, there's artillery. I try to shoot this guy, but my shell, I think, hits the ground just in front of him. Then I get shot. I don't know what shot me. I think it was the T-92. Then there's a Panzer IV-H and a Tiger II-H that have showed up. I decide to be risky and pop out anyways to try and get this Panzer IV for an easy little kill. I manage it, and that puts me up to 5 or 6 kills. I don't remember. I know it says Shadow Streak 5, but I don't know if Shadow Strike... pops up after your first kill or on your second kill. Or after your second kill, I mean. And I try to get another shot at this T-92, but just when I fire, he gets blown up by a Panzer IV G on our team. And my team is pushed into the cap zone, and now we're capping. Now I'm going to do my... And it was at this point where I decided, you know what? I've pretty much already got that other task, that battle task, finished. Okay, I've got 5 kills, it looks like. Yeah. So I decided, you know what? Now I'm actually going to really play for the match as best as I can. Now we have an enemy plane jumping into... Or we have an enemy player jumping into a plane, and he's the top player on the enemy team. So I'm worried that he's going to just come for me. I have this paranoia for planes coming after me, because it's arcade. I think everybody has that paranoia. So I kind of get behind this rock. I don't see him anywhere, but I'm keeping an eye open. Not that there's much I can do. And I see our flak shooting this way, and here he comes. Good old dumbass he is. Magic Marker, you are a gutless scumbag in this game, and you deserve no right for that kind of kill. I hope nobody has to play against that guy, because he doesn't fly the plane in arcade. I don't know why Gaijin doesn't do anything about that, honestly. Like, is that really what Gaijin envisions for arcade? Because I want to make this fan trailer of arcade ground forces where it's just planes smashing into the ground and suiciding into tanks. But anyways, I get a kill on the Sturmiel. Very, very tricky shot there. He was only exposing a little bit of his vehicle. Then I notice this Panzer IIIM, and I'm like, what the fuck is that Panzer IIIM doing there? And then there's a heavy tank, and I pull back, because I don't know what that heavy tank is, and I don't know if he's coming for me or not. And as I pull back out, suddenly, out of freaking nowhere, as I'm shooting my machine guns, here comes this fucking IS-2 comes blazing across. I almost didn't get that shot off, because I didn't notice him at first. But I guess he was trying to make a run across, didn't expect a Panther II to be watching. And I decide to start pulling out. We've still got the zone. We've got a few vehicles up there. And I'm going to start moving up so that I can shoot any enemy tanks that come from their spawn to head for the cap zone. And yes, I am trying to make a sneaky attack on that Panzer III. But as I'm moving this way, I notice that there's a whole bunch of enemy tanks on the other side of this hill. And also down the way, kind of like where I'm looking a little bit to the left, down that way. So I'm worried that these guys are going to pop out when I try to drive over, and the first one is a Tiger H1. So I kind of drive up next to this rock to see if I can get a shot. He notices me, but thankfully I got my shot away first, and his side was exposed, so I pull back. And I drive up onto this ridge to start shooting at some enemy tanks that drive out. My first target is the T-25, then the Comet spots me, gets a shot into my turret, wounds a few of my targets, and as he's driving away, I get a nice strike on this, and I didn't notice this. There's a Panzer III over there, so I prepare to shoot, and, well, my life was ended by a KV-2 that I didn't notice at first. If I would have noticed the KV-2, I would have moved. So that ends my first vehicle, the Panther II. So I jump into my Tiger II HSLA-16, which, spoilers, is also a short-lived drive. I'm not sure what I'm up to in terms of kills at this moment. I haven't been keeping track. But I know I'm up there pretty high, and that's why I kind of wanted to win the match for a good amount of RP. So, the Tiger II HSLA-16 is a very fun vehicle to drive. There's a Challenger over there. I try to line up for a shot on him, but... there's a whole bunch of stuff between me and him. And I start moving forward, and I notice that we're starting to get pushed out of the A zone, it looks like. We're losing vehicles over there. And I saw the scoreboard, and you could see that we were losing in terms of numbers against the enemy. And that was really starting to piss me off now, because we were doing really, really good. And I start moving up, and I can see this medium tank on the mini-map. And I'm thinking he's up here around the corner, but then I notice that he's moving. So I pull back to take a strike at whatever it is that comes around the corner. I was expecting it to be the Panzer IIIM, but it's not. And a shot through it did not kill the fucking T-34. And I wasn't paying attention to the minimap. But then I'm stuck sideways here. And I get shot in the side by a fucking Panzer IV G. And this T-34 gets his turret back up, and he shoots me. Well, no, he doesn't shoot me. Somebody else shoots me. I think the Panzer III did. I killed that guy. That was probably a mistake. If I wouldn't have killed the T-34, I would have gotten a shot on this Panzer IV G and killed him. Then the Challenger comes around the corner, doesn't shoot at the M-18 or the other tank shooting at him. He's going straight for me. And there was nothing I could have done at that point. If I would have shot that Panzer IV G in the first place instead of the T-34, I wouldn't have been dead. But, well, you saw how that went. So right now we're winning. But you could look at the numbers. Look at the scoreboard. It's ridiculous. We're getting our asses handed to us now. And now they're capping. So I'm just in a glorious mood. So I decide I'm going to push for the cap this time. And actually see what I can do. There's that fucking Panzer IV G that killed me. So I'm going to obviously get a shot on this guy so nothing's striking me. There's a Tiger H1 down there. There's a Panther D way off in the distance. And they've just capped the A point. Okay, so I got some revenge on that Panzer IV G. And I pull back. And then that Tiger H1 shows up. And he stopped and he's lining up a shot on me. But I managed to get my shot off first. And I go through, knock out his driver and his gunner. So all I have to do is reload and put a shot through his middle and finish him off. So, now my job is to move towards the A point. I think that Challenger was killed, because we've got an M24 moving up, and the rest of my team really isn't moving up at all. It's up to me and this M24 to push up and try and get the cap zone. So, yes, I am actually trying to win here instead of just sitting back like I usually do on most other matches when I'm not really trying to win. T-34-85 shows up, he gets shot, tries to pull back, I finish him off. Then there's an M26. I pull back while I'm reloading to prepare to move out. The M24 does a really stupid thing and just pulls right out into the middle of everywhere and gets himself killed. And I notice that there's a Sherman out there. I think is that a jumbo? Yeah, that's a jumbo Sherman. There's a Panther D up there. And I'm trying to look for a moment that I can move. Oh, shit! I take this really wicky shot, or a really tricky shot at this guy, and managed to actually kill him. Wasn't expecting to do that. It's one less enemy gun I have to worry about. Then I notice the Panther D's backing off, so I should be safe to move up. Now, there's a medium tank right in front of me on the mini-map, but as far as I know, it's just a Panzer IV F2. But I'm not feeling too lucky against Panzer IVs right now, because I was just killed by one before, even though he was shooting through my side. But when I notice that he pops out and shoots, I decide just to charge him anyways. I mean, he's going to be reloaded, but I charge him and make a pretty lucky shot there. I could have hit that invisible fucking rock. I'm pretty sure that rock has one too. And I kill the little pesky Panzer IV. Now I'm moving up, and I'm starting to turn towards the cap zone. Right now, all I can see is that M26. It's the only thing that's in the cap zone. There is a Panther D further back, but he's not too dangerous at the moment for me. I'm trying to figure out how to get this guy. And I don't know if you can shoot through the buildings. I don't know if they have collision or not, so I don't waste a shell. Then I'm getting shot by this freaking Panther D, I think, with his machine gun. And I didn't realize, apparently, these guys can hit me over this rock. Because the Yag Panther here shoots, hits the rock in front of me, but does wound one of my crew members. So despite the fact that I hit the fucking invisible rock there, the tip top of my turret is poking over that, and they can still shoot and hit me. What the fuck, Gaijin? But I pull out and take that advantage to take out the Yag Panther. Then another gutless scumbag, Crazy 0096, suicides into the Panther D and kills him. So now I'm making a rush for the fucking cap zone as quickly as possible to kill that M26 and decap. Unfortunately, the M26 is currently sitting in the cap, so I can't just start decapping right away. And the rest of my team has basically pushed up in the middle of the map towards their spawn. Now, I was getting kind of panicky here because how low the ticket counter is getting. And the M26 notices me. I thought that would kill him, but it missed his ammo by like an inch. So all it killed was his freaking machine gun. And I'm trying to get this guy. I thought he was trying to side scrape. See, I'm getting really panicky. I shoot into his engine. I mean, look at the tickets. We're at 300, 200. We're below 300 now. Oh, shit, we're about to be below 100. And I pull forward, reload, fucking reload. He's about to shoot. Oh, okay. He's dead. And we're on 42 tickets. We can win this as long as nobody fucking dies. Then Here comes a fucking scumbag in his IL-10. He rockets and crits our STA-1 while dropping the bombs on him, which finishes him off, because the STA-1, as far as I know, was unable to move. And while I might have finished my task, my battle task, the match I was trying to win so hard after receiving 18 fucking kills and 2 assists results in a defeat. A disappointing result with only 8,713 RP. You might be thinking, only? Yeah, 7,000 RP is my average. 7,000 to 9,000 is my average on a victory. Imagine what 8,000 on a defeat would have been on a victory. I would have had between 11,000 and 15,000 RP of a reward there. But I haven't. And this was also something that pissed me off again. I am still hammering this in. It, one of the worst decisions Gaijin could have ever made. War Thunder used to be this game that rewarded you for personal performance. It rewarded each individual player. That way you never had to rely on your team. You could still play as a team. You could still play as a lone wolf. But Gaijin are basically trying to force players to work together, which doesn't fucking work. This just goes to show, in this area, they have no brain cells with how online games work. And what they do is they will hurt the actual performance of you if you lose. If you lose, you get shit for reward compared to a victory. You get victory bonuses now. Oh, you don't get victory bonuses. You get victories are normal RP gain. Defeats, you basically get you lose actual gain instead of not getting a bonus. No, you straight up lose RP gain and silver line. I don't know about silver lines, but RP is what's important to me right now. And that's fucking stupid. So no longer, even after playing a match with 18 fucking ground kills, we still lose, and I get punished for it by not earning as much RP as I normally would because my team lost. Which, even though my team was doing good and during the earlier parts and then started to fall apart, and I pushed to help at the very end, finishing top of my team, I don't get rewarded for personal performance anymore. Instead, the fact that we lost. And it's not really my team's fault. It's more the fault of the fucking gutless scumbag that just suicided into the ground at the very end. That's why we lost. That STA-1, it wasn't his fault. There was nothing he could do. There's nothing any of us can do against one of those players. And that's, again, something else I have to say. Is this really what Gaijin envisions for Arcade Ground Forces? Do they really say, they really sit back and say, yes, Arcade Ground Forces is this lovely game mode where you can fly aircraft and crash into the ground to get easy hit kills every time. Is that what they think Arcade Ground Forces is? It boggles my mind why this is still in the game. Why they force planes on and balance them so poorly so dumbasses can just crash into the ground every 2 seconds for an easy kill, making no possibility that the other player is going to survive. There are times they can survive, but most of the time they can't. And there's nothing you can do. It doesn't matter if you're in a heavily armored tank, a mouse, doesn't matter. Just suicide into you, kill you anyways. Doesn't matter if you're in a fast tank, they just suicide into you while you're moving, you're dead. It just doesn't matter. Really, Gaijin, that's really what Arcade Ground Forces... That's really what... Because the game mode is called Tank Arcade. Tank Arcade. Not Tank and Air Arcade. It's called Tank Arcade. Just like Air Arcade is aircraft only. Player-controlled air only. Hell, there's a fucking game mode that air domination where it's only planes and there's not even a single AI ground target in the match. It's only planes. There are so many air things where there are no player-controlled ground. Air gets everything. Air gets combined and its own stuff, but ground has to be forced to play with aircraft every time, every event, every game mode. Tank duels. Oh, there's planes in it. events. Oh, there's planes in it. Simulator ground forces. Oh, there's planes that can spawn in right away in it. Realistic ground forces. Oh, there's planes that you can unlock with, or there's planes you can get through spawn points. Arcade ground forces. Oh, there's aircraft that can fly every 10 seconds in that game mode, depending on who has score. And all you gotta do is fart at somebody and you'll get enough score to spawn in a fucking bomber. Bombers aren't even deadly in the game mode, never mind. Fucking attacker. Why can't ground forces get its own fucking thing instead of plaguing it with these assholes in their aircraft that just smash into the ground because you can? That's the only reason why.